So, let's go on to the kings of Eurovision. Kings and queens. Sweden are the princes and princesses, but these are the kings and queens, and that is Ireland. Ireland have won it 7 times. 7 times. That's the most any country have won it. They have not won it in this millennia, though. They have struggled in the last 20 years. They owned the 90s. They completely owned the 90s. They won 3 times in the 90s. It's ridiculous. Twice in the 80s by the same artist, in 81 and in 87. I remember 87. Oh, we were kind of. We had small crushes, not like in love crushes, but oh, we thought it was so beautiful. Hold me now, don't cry, don't say a word, just. Oh, we really loved John Logan. I don't think his first one is as good as the one, What's Another Year is not as good. And then in the 90s, he won again as a composer, so he has won 3 times. And then Ireland won twice again in the 90s. So they kind of ruled the 90s, owned the 90s. But what happened? What happened quite a bit, and all that has also happened to other countries, and I will come to that in the next bunch of countries. With a big five. Televoting happened. Televoting and enlarging the participation, the number of countries that are participating. To start with, the earliest years, that's when we talk about this, when which countries vote for which countries and which countries vote for each other and things like that. That was really big in the 2000s and early 2010s, but not that much in the 2010s. It was in the first decade of the 2000s of this millennia. And they were all new to this then. So all of course you needed to vote for your neighbor countries and things like that. And we still do it to a degree, but not the same way, because I think we do it because we are biased now. I tend to like the Nordic countries because they have the kind of the same musical culture as I have, so I can really understand the influences and things like that. And the same thing must be the same for the Balkans and for the Eastern European countries and things like that. So that's how it kind of comes naturally that we vote for our close neighbors. We have a bias against towards them, not against them, towards them. And what happened to Ireland then? Well, they don't have any, close friends in Europe. They are kind of friendly and kind of friends with everyone, but not like that. They don't have that feel that they are part of, like, the Nordic countries or the Balkan countries, the Baltic countries. They don't have that feel. They are quite mainstream. And the same thing goes for UK and for France and for a lot of other countries. It's more difficult for them. And Ireland can just, and also regular people, because when it was juries doing this, they did it also to an extent, but not as much as when people started voting. When it was juries, they always looked to the musical qualities, and also then always where you had the rules where you had to sing in your own in your own language, the official language. Like Switzerland, they could choose for choose between four languages because they have four official languages. Finland could have sung in Finnish or Swedish because Swedish is also, or at least was, I don't think it is anymore. I'm not sure. You can correct me if I'm wrong. I don't think Swedish is an official language in Sweden anymore. In Finland anymore, sorry. So that's also one way, because Ireland, I said it when it came to Malta as well, Ireland and the UK, they and Malta, they were the countries who were singing in English, and everyone knew English because everyone had studied some English, so we understood the lyrics better. So I think that is one thing. Everyone could all of a sudden sing in English, and then they didn't have that heads up anymore. So, and also at times they have just kind of shat on the competition, hasn't they? They have sent these troll entrances, like the turkey. Irlande, douze bois. But I remember them. Irlande, douze bois. Irlande, douze bois. It was, yeah. So, yeah, come on then. Let's see, Ireland. What do you have in store for us this year? Oh, she's pink. Happy, a bit very uplifting right now from this ballads and heavy songs that I've just listened through. So it was a nice break in that. It was decent enough. Sure. Would it qualify for the final? Not sure. Not for sure. It was good enough. She was happy, and it depends. I like the video very much because it was really, yeah, talking about that everyone is okay the way they are. And yeah, I like the video good enough. I'm not sure that this would qualify, but it could. Wouldn't annoy me if it would have. But yeah, sure. It was okay. Bye.